I'm Dr. Catherine Lai, and I am the Director of Leukemia at MedStar Georgetown University Hospital. I see patients with leukemias, both acute and chronic leukemias, as well as patients who have pre-leukemia. In terms of acute and chronic leukemias, it spans a wide range of ages, but predominantly the patients tend to be older, with the median age being in their 60s. In terms of acute leukemias, I think of these as leukemias where patients have symptoms that develop over days to weeks, as opposed to the chronic leukemias where patients have symptoms over months to years. My approach to patient care is really taking the whole patient into consideration and also thinking about their social situation in regards to their family, since treatment is very time intensive. I think it's very important to get other services involved, such as social work, physical medicine if necessary, and any other consultants as well. The other thing I would say is I like my patients to be very informed and educated about their disease, so giving them as much information as needed so that they can make educated decisions. It's very rewarding to treat leukemia patients because they often come in very sick. And so by treating the patients and putting their disease into remission, I'm able to improve both their quality of life as well as their duration of life. Patients should come to MedStar Georgetown because leukemias are not that common relative to other cancers in the United States. And so it's important for patients to see a specialist who only treats leukemia. The thing that inspires me to continue to treat my patients and to learn about leukemia is improving the outcomes. We haven't made progress in the leukemia world in terms of treatment, really until recently. And so if over my lifetime I can be a part of that change and make a difference, that is what keeps me going. Leukemia is a blood cancer, and more specifically, it's a cancer of the bone marrow. So then, what is bone marrow? So your bone marrow is important for three main functions. The first being it makes your immune system, so the cells of your that fight infection. The second is it produces your red blood cells, or the blood that circulates throughout your body. And the third is your platelets, which you need if you were to, say, cut yourself so that you don't bleed significantly. So what happens when you have a cancer of the bone marrow is that one, two, or all three of those lines can be affected. And so patients have symptoms of either increased infections or they get tired because their blood level is low, or they have more frequent bruising or bleeding. And so those are the clinical manifestations of a leukemia. The cause of leukemia is unknown. For the majority of patients, they're just unfortunately unlucky. We know historically there have been major exposures that have caused leukemias, but those, you know, we know about and have since fallen out of favor, such as the atomic bomb and significant benzene or chemical exposure. But since patients aren't exposed to those anymore, at this point it's just bad luck. In terms of signs and symptoms of leukemia, it's pretty nonspecific because it's a cancer of the bone marrow, and often patients don't manifest symptoms until the disease is pretty severe, which is very common. So often patients can just feel fatigued. Sometimes they can have fevers or night sweats. They might have easy bruising or bleeding as well. With chronic leukemias, the symptoms are much different. Patients are often asymptomatic, and it's picked up on a routine blood test with a patient's internal medicine physician. An area that's very exciting in the field of leukemia is how we detect the disease. We are working on tests that use the peripheral blood as opposed to doing a more traditional bone marrow biopsy to detect the disease. And so that is one major advance that we've made in the last 5 to 10 years, with the goal that if we can detect the disease in the blood sooner, that we can predict relapse sooner and more closely monitor and treat patients better. Leukemias fall under blood cancers, which are very different than solid tumors such as breast, lung, or colon cancer, in that they're treated with chemotherapy alone, either through the IV or in pill form, as opposed to solid tumors, which are traditionally treated with a combination of surgery, chemotherapy, and radiation. For the most part, leukemia is not hereditary. There's a few rare genetic syndromes that patients have when they're very young that predispose them to leukemia later on in life. But for the most part, leukemia is not something that is inherited or that is passed down to their children. Treatment for leukemia, I would divide it into acute leukemia and chronic leukemia. So treatment for acute leukemia, again, which is the leukemia where the disease comes on very quickly, it needs more intensive chemotherapy. So we treat it with cytotoxic chemotherapy given about a week, and then patients remain in the hospital for about 1 to 2 months waiting for their blood levels to improve, as well as treating any side effects that occur from the chemotherapy. Now, in terms of chronic leukemias, we've made a lot of progress over the last 10 to 20 years in terms of how we treat it. And we've moved away from the cytotoxic chemotherapy. And for the majority of patients, chronic leukemias can be treated with a targeted agent, which is typically taken as a pill form every day. Treatment does make patients feel tired. Everybody is different, and there's no way to know which patients are going to feel tired and which ones aren't. There's also an important distinction to make in that just because a patient has side effects or doesn't have side effects, that doesn't correlate at all with whether or not the treatment is working. The patients who need to be treated in the hospital are the patients who have acute leukemias, and that can range anywhere from 1 to 2 weeks to up to 1 to 2 months. For the chronic leukemias, sometimes patients need to be treated in the hospital in the very beginning when we don't know the diagnosis, and for a few days after we have the diagnosis, but typically after that, it's something that for the chronic leukemias, patients are just coming to clinic on a regular basis. In terms of treatment for leukemias, again, I think of it as chronic and acute. For the acute leukemias, if a patient isn't treated, unfortunately the prognosis is poor and patients will often only live about 1 or 2 months. For chronic leukemias, because again, it's a cancer that we hope the patient dies with as opposed to dies from, sometimes they don't require treatment in the beginning, and it's not until the burden of disease becomes such at which we need treatment. But again, the landscape for chronic leukemias is much different, and most of the patients with chronic leukemias can live a normal life if they get treatment. Immunotherapy is a very exciting treatment for cancer in general. Immunotherapy works by harnessing the body's own immune system, either with an infusion of a drug or a manipulation of the patient's own cells to then fight the cancer. In leukemia, it is an area of research, but we haven't found a home run yet, but we are working on different combinations of immunotherapies to better treat leukemias. Clinical trials offer an opportunity for patients to receive a treatment that they wouldn't otherwise receive, or that is not standard. So the benefit is that they have exposure to the latest cancer drug that has the potential to put their leukemia into remission. So MedStar Georgetown offers clinical trials for leukemia patients, and it's always a good option to consider. Clinical trials for leukemias are a way to potentially get a novel treatment that a patient wouldn't otherwise be eligible for or be covered by your insurance. It's a way to receive a treatment when there are no other options. Leukemias in general, both acute and chronic, are diseases that we have good treatments for, and the treatments will put the disease into remission. However, the disease doesn't stay in remission unless patients either continue treatment indefinitely or get what's called a bone marrow transplant. A bone marrow transplant is the only way to cure an acute leukemia. It's done by giving a patient a new immune system. And before that, the patient has to be in remission for their leukemia. And then they get their current immune system is completely wiped out. And then we infuse somebody else's immune system into the patient, either from a relative or somebody who's unrelated to them. People should come to MedStar Georgetown because it offers a unique experience in that we treat the whole patient. And by that, I mean that we really take a multidisciplinary approach to make sure that all aspects of both the leukemia as well as other factors are approached in terms of, with regards to the leukemia, seeing a leukemia specialist, but then also making sure that patients are seeing a social worker, the oncology nurse, the nutritionist, occupational and physical therapy if necessary, as well as any other additional services that may play a role.